reaching this pinnacle. Norwalk Raceway Park is the Daytona of drag racing. 1,000 drag racers have journeyed here to compete for the biggest bragging rights of all. Central Ohio is home to Norwalk Raceway Park, the premier speed palace in all of drag racing. The Mopar Parts World Nationals comes home to TNN next.
Grandstand Canyon will be jam-packed this weekend for one reason, to watch the best drag racers in the world try to lay claim to champion of the Mopar Parts World Nationals. Leave a split second quicker than your competitor at the starting line, you win. Get to the finish line a split second after him, you lose. Winning is everything. Winning the Mopar Parts Nationals means even more. Tommy Johnson Jr., what do you think?
That's right, Ralph. This is the event every racer looks forward to on the tour. Put your name on the trophy here, you not only won the race, you become part of IHRA history. We've moved into the second half of the season. The points battles are tightening up. Every round win is critically important. Win the title in Top Fuel at the Mopar Parts World Nationals, you could be declared the favorite going into the title chase. Aaron Polburn, what's happening in the Pro Modified pit area?
Well, Tommy, I said earlier in the year that as long as you're qualified for a Pro Modified race, you had a chance to win it. But you know, that may not be true here. Well, unless your name is Stott or maybe Pat Moore. You know, the championship is on the line. But remember, don't ever, ever bet on a drag race.
I'm betting we're going to have a great drag race here at Norwalk Raceway Park. We're in Ohio for the Mopar Parts World Nationals, presented by Ethanol for Forbes. Today, we're going to give you the lowdown on Top Fuel, Pro Mod, and Nitro bikes. The Pro Stock and Funny Car battles continue to tighten, and we're going to present the semifinals and finals of each class in order. Stay with us. This is a fast ride here on TNN. This facility is unequaled in all of drag racing. Check out the new pitside stands these fans are enjoying. So where did the old stands go? Well, remember these fans at Grand Bend, Ontario? They're standing on the old stands from Ohio. Now that's my kind of recycling. Hey, we'll be back with Pro Modified in just a second, right here on TNN. All East Spring Nationals in Rockingham. Then we're on to the first time to Virginia Motorsports Park, the newest venue on the IHRA schedule, and everybody is pumped up about that one. Our second trip to Grand Bend is next, followed by Cordova, Illinois, Leicester, New York, and Stanton, Michigan. Then, of course, we're back here for the World Nationals and the championship at Shreveport. And TNN will have all that action for you. Here is the Mopar Pro Modified ladder. And guess what? 1, 2, 3, and 4 work right through the ladder, and they're all going to the semifinals. Quain Stott and Ronnie Hood will go head-to-head, and then Mitch Stott will go up against Ed Hoover. But, hey, what happened to the Summit car?
Well, Ralph, we saw Freddie Hahn leading the points championship this year, did not qualify for this event, had problems during qualifying. You see right there, Fred Hahn on top of points, but that may disappear now that he did not make the show this weekend.
Well, Quain Stott's into the semis, Tommy, so he has a good opportunity to pick up some points. Al Billis sits third, and Ed Hoover, also in the semis, can move up into the points. And in the first round, Quain would go up against Tommy Gray, a car we haven't seen in a while, but Quain is really coming on strong lately, Tommy.
Well, at the start of this season, Quain was just another Pro Modified, but he's really coming to stride. As you can see here, the performance of that car is outstanding, a 635 getting rid of Tommy Gray in the first round.
Steve Vick would find out just how strong the Lee Boy car has been as well, as he would match up against Quain in round number two action.
He's been working on the tune-up in the nitrous-powered car. A lot of controversy with the blown cars. Quain Stott hasn't paid any attention to it. You can see him thunder into a 633 win with nitrous oxide.
And brother Mitch Stott not running so bad either. He would match up against Tim McCamus right here in this black vet in round number one.
Well, I'm sure the two of them are sharing information. They're brothers. They race together, so a lot of information probably shared between two cars, and it's paying off as now as Mitch Stott takes the win over Tim McCamus.
Well, Mitch would move on to round number two, where he would match up against Billy Harper and the Viper, and this car has been running better than Viper, but, Tommy, you got to get it off the line.
Well, you can see these two guys come to the starting line, second round of Pro Modified. But the good performance, it won't do any good when you leave a red light on the starting line like that. Mitch Stott getting awfully lucky. I don't know if he saw the red light, shut the car off, trying to save parts, or he had a mechanical failure. They'll have to go back to the pit area, see what was wrong with the car, and get it ready for his next round of competition.
And the potential for a pair of Stott brothers in the finals.
Wayne, a good chance you might be meeting up with your brother in a final round for the first time. Pretty special?
Yeah, it would be. Of course, I'd like to kick his butt, but it ought to be special. But you know what the important thing is? Fred is dead.
Do you remember how to win?
Yes, sir. It's been a couple of years. Well, probably about 3 years, I guess, since I've had that wind bulb in the finals. But I'm blood hungry. I'm thirsty. And I, hopefully, Quain and I can get past this next round. I'm about like Force, you know. I want the snake in the finals. That's who I want. I want him. I'm taking him out. You can mark that and down. If we can get there, he's mine.
Let's take a look at the Pro Modified Final Four. Ed Hoover, who has won the first race this year, haven't heard a lot from him since, but he's still in the top five in Pro Modified points. Mitch Stott, with the help probably from his brother, Quain, on the tune-up in that car, has made the semifinals in Pro Modified, wanting to meet up with his brother. Ronnie Hood, who has quietly been lurking in the top 10 in points in Pro Modified, has now made his way to the semifinals and looking for that first victory. And Quain Stott, who has come on strong in the middle of the season, now winning the races and the car to beat in Pro Modified.
Is if you're a Corvette fan, well, we got some great racing for you here in Pro Modified. All four of our semifinalists in the bow tie bodies.
Not only Quain Stott looks like the car to be, but it looks like the Corvette's the car to be.
Yeah, sure does. All right, getting set for the first semi. Ronnie Hood in the near lane, the Grizzly car against the Lee Boy machine of Quain Stott.
Both these cars, 9th horsepower, naturally aspirated with carburetors, Ralph.
First one off the line is Hood. He did what he needed to now. Where's the Lee Boy horsepower? Here comes Stott. He gets him at the far end. 634, 223 miles an hour. And you saw Father Stott jumping up in the air.
Well, you can see both cars leave dead even, but there was about 10 miles per hour difference in the two, Ralph. And you can see him pull away right there. That's 10 miles per hour difference in the two cars.
The next pair of events, Mitch Stott up against Ed Hoover.
Two more Corvettes matching up here in the semifinal round. Car of choice this weekend.
And we saw Ronnie Hood had to get the jump on Quain, I would believe. We got to see, oh, and Hoover was looking for the jump and went a little too hard. Red lights and big problems for Mitch Stott.
Well, we can see a fire underneath the car, Ralph. The car backfired when it left the starting line. You can see it out the hood scoop there. Big fire on the car. It's gas in the carburetors, belching out to the top of the carburetors, catching the hood scoop on fire, and they'll get that put out, and he'll be back for the next round because we saw a foul start by Ed Hoover, giving the easy win to Mitch Stott.
Yeah, but Tommy, he's also got a lot of work to do now to get that car ready that he wouldn't normally have had to do.
They get an hour and a half, Ralph, to get these cars fixed and back to the line, but now that team's got a lot of extra work to do. They're going to be pressing it to get to the starting line, but let's remember, it might be his lucky day. Two red lights in a row. We've seen some problems up the starting line with that car, but it might be his lucky day to get his first victory.
Well, we got a battle between brothers coming up in the finals of Pro Modified. And, you know, if you don't like nitrous, how about nitro? We got some of that coming your way, too. Stay with us. His fear is fire, and we saw that already today. Watch the car on the left, Mitch Stott, as the flames start to belch out of the hood. Tommy, no fun there.
Boy, Ralph, I've been a lot of fires in the funny car, and they're not any fun at all. I'd rather hit something than have a fire.
I seen the fire. We seen what was going on there. We lost the needle and seat adjuster on the right front carburetor there. It started burning about the time I pulled second gear, and that's when I started to see the flames. They started coming inside the car just a little bit. You know, get the ignition off, get the fire bottle out, that kind of thing. I've said my prayers before each round, too. So he's riding with me, and hey, we still taking her to the finals with Big Brother. I think, I don't know if this is IHRA or a world first or what, two brothers pro class in the finals together. I don't know, but he's mine. Tell him he's mine. I want him. I want him now. Right now.
Mittstott's going to face Quainstott in the final round of Pro Modified, and there's no doubt how Quainstott got to the final. The performance of that car has been outstanding as of late.
How proud are you of your brother right now?
I'm proud of him. I'm a little worried about him. You know, a fire is a dangerous thing in these cars. That's our biggest worry is a fire. So kind of worried me a little bit when he was flaming out there. But hell, he's tough. He can handle it.
When you guys were growing up, who was the bully and who got picked on?
I don't know. Mitch always says he was the better looking, but I think I was the meanest.
So you're going to nail him?
I'm going to nail him. He's done. I mean, I'd like to see Mitch win his first ever final, but it's going to have to be beside somebody besides me.
Have you ever had a prouder moment than right now? This is
never
pretty special.
Never in my life. Never. Been the most proudest time I've ever had in my life. It's what I've dreamed for.
Well, I notice here you got Leboy on one side, you got Radiac on the other. Oh, how you going to root?
I'm going to root for Mitch. Well, I told him, load it up. We're going to outrun Quain. We got to.
I guess it's a little tough when you're dad and you got to pick which brother you're going to cheer for. Here's the way they got there. Quainstott put away Ronnie Hood, and Mittstott put away Ed Hoover.
You don't think there was any wrestling matches when those two were younger, do you, there, Ralph?
There might be one after this final. Here's Mittstott in the Radiac car. Says he's going to take out Big Brother. Big Brother says he was the tougher one of the two when they were growing up, and he's going to put a chokehold on him in the finals here.
Both these cars got to the final round in totally different ways. Quainstott running outstanding performance all day. Mittstott being awful lucky. A couple red lights, had some problems. We'll see if he got them fixed in the final round.
And Mitch hasn't made a full run pass here in a while. Let's see how he does. Mitch is quicker off the line, but gets sideways.
Quainstott making another great run. The Pro Modified 660 at 211. Takes out his brother Mitch.
I think maybe the fact that Mitch didn't make any full runs in the later parts of the day might have seriously affected the performance of that car, Tommy. He didn't know what it was going to do.
Well, definitely. You saw the car stumble off the starting line the last few runs. This time it leaves with full power, gets out of shape. So maybe that had a lot to do with the final round.
Pretty wild run out there.
Yeah, man. I mean, Mitch trying to play some kind of staging games with me up there on the starting line. I don't know what he was up to, but anyway, I said, hell, he can wait a minute. So we went on in stage, and I let the clutch out. It felt good. I thought I had him off the tree. When I put that sucker in second gear, it about drawed a donut out there on us. And I said, well, hell, I ain't letting off because I know he's back there somewhere, so he ain't going to win it this way. So I brought her on home.
World championship. Now it's maybe in your reach.
Like I told you earlier, Fred's dead.
Well, here's the point, and Fred's not in the lead, at least. He might not be dead, but he's in second. Quainstott is the new points leader in the Mopar Pro Mod point standing.
Why do you think people come to Norwalk Raceway Park for the Mopar Parts World Nationals? Is it 300-mile-per-hour top-fuel dragsters? Nah. Pro Modifieds? Nah. This is the deal right here. Come here. This is 1 pound of ice cream for $1. You're going to love that stuff. 1 pound for $1, only at Norwalk Raceway Park.
You know, the IHRA.com Funny Car Points battle has been seesawing back and forth all year. First, Jimmy Rector here in the black and white car takes the win to Darlington and the points lead. Well, then we move on up the road a little bit to Rockingham, North Carolina, where Scott Winnie in the left lane takes the win. And the points lead away from Rector. Well, as we moved up through the year, Von Smith even had the points lead for a while, but then he lost it with a first-round loss to Lester and gave it back to Winnie, who blew the body and lost some points, but still holds on to the points lead as we head into this round of action. So this thing is really tightening up. Winnie up front, but Von Smith, Rector, all still within striking distance. This one probably won't be settled till we get to the end of the year at Shreveport. Tommy, how about the brackets for Funny Car?
Well, the brackets this weekend, Billy Gibson, number one qualifier, fifth in points. That's not going to hurt his chances to try and move up in the standings. Number two qualifier, Scott Winnie, will take on Jimmy Rector, number three in the points.
Well, let's get right to that points battle with number one in the points, Scott Winnie, taking on number three in the points, Jimmy Rector.
The points battle's got to be weighing a little bit on their minds when they pull up here to the semifinal round, but you got to put that out of your mind when you roll up here to the starting line. Concentrate on the Christmas tree, be on time, and that's how you maintain that points lead.
Both cars staged.
Bring the RPMs up. They leave at about 5,000 RPMs. They drop the clutch on these cars, and they're gone.
And Winnie's gone quicker.
Almost dead even off the start line. You see Winnie's car make a little move, but he pulls out the win. 589, 237 miles per hour. Knocks out Rector and advances that points lead.
Well, that's exactly what he needs to do, because coming up in the next pair, two more cars in the top five in points, and Winnie needs to keep stacking those points if he wants to win this IHRA.com Funny Car Championship.
You can see Winnie's car leave the start line with the wheels in the air. The car moving to the right, couldn't get it back to the left until he set the front end down, and the car streaked to a victory over Jimmy Rector.
Well, Billy Gibson here in the near lane, who is the number one qualifier here and is fifth in the point standings, takes on Vaughn Smith in this semifinal. Smith, number two in the points.
Billy Gibson leaves the starting line right with Vaughn Smith. Vaughn with a little advantage, but you can see the horsepower coming into play. Vaughn Smith, 599, takes the win over Billy Gibson, 603.
Let's take a look at the replay of this one, and this one was pretty much decided at the far end because they left pretty much even off the line. But boy, Vaughn Smith and the Nitro Fish just starts to pull away, Tommy.
Boy, made a nice straight run. No problems, no tire shake. Definitely got the tune-up figured out for that run of 599.
It's kind of like old times now. You and Scott going at it again. It's what a battle.
I tell you, it's just, you know, we're going to have the same thing that happened to us at New York happened to him. That's the way it is. I mean,
you are as comfortable as you have been, even though right now, let's go back. Three races ago, if you were a tenth behind going to a final round, I'd have come over here and you were ready to rip my head off. Right now, that's not the case, and that normally wins a lot of races.
Well, that's true, but I'm just enjoying racing right now. And you know, like I said, tomorrow will be a different story, or Monday, whenever we get home, will be a different story, because I'll be thinking about bills and making it to the next one. But right now, I'm just trying to go round and round and try to stay with Scott.
Good luck.
Thank you, man. Appreciate you.
Scott, you've been racing well over 20 years. What makes this year so different?
Well, I don't know. It's just all falling our way. It's still, it's a real tight race with the points. We're running Vaughn again in the final. Just can't get away from him. And it'll be a fight to the end, but hopefully we'll come out on top. That's the plan anyhow.
Well, every time you win a round, you pick up 20 points in IHRA competition. So as these guys move their way out of the semis and into the main event here today, those 20 points are very important.
Well, it's an awfully important final round to Vaughn Smith. He has to keep Scott Winnie within reach. Can't let him get those extra 20 points on him with a round victory. And we're going to see Vaughn Smith give it everything he's got for this final round.
Now there's another 20 points up for grabs. Vaughn Smith would love to have him. There's a good look at Vaughn and that Nitro Fish. As he comes into this one, sitting in the point standings, number two behind Scott Winnie, the point leader. And Winnie has been so strong at the starting line.
Well, Winnie drives a bracket car, has a little dragster on the weekends. I got the same thing. Keeps you sharp on a Christmas tree, and we've seen Scott Winnie win a lot of races on a hole shot this year, so maybe that's his key to success this year.
Heard a lot about guys practicing with trees in the house. You like practicing at the track better?
Well, it's just not the same. The conditions on start line are a lot different.
And Vaughn Smith gets a much better jump off the line. But look how his car's all over the track. Winnie goes straight down the boulevard and picks up the win.
We can see Vaughn Smith drive more than a quarter of a mile, Ralph. And Scott Winnie made a nice straight run right and straight down the racetrack.
So Scott Winnie gets the win and the extra 20 points.
Scott Winnie, I am starting to believe everybody now, this could be the year of the Winnie. What do you think?
Jeez, I hope so. It's a lot of work. It's a lot of work for all the guys that work on the car. A lot of work for me. Big expense for Ken, so hopefully it'll all pay off in the end.
A major jump in the World Championship points. This was important to stay actually a little bit ahead of Vaughn now.
Well, it's not a major jump. It's only another 20 points ahead, but it adds to what we already had. So we're building a cushion that we lost at the last race.
Well, congratulations again, Mopar Parts, Funny Car Champion. Good job.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Scott.
Thanks. Well, every point you can get, Tommy, as you know, you've chased some points before. Every point you get is a big one, and Winnie just picked up 20 more.
Boy, did he put a little space between himself and Vaughn Smith and really stretched it out over Jimmy Rector.
You know, this simple drive chain departed from a Screaming Eagle Nitro Harley at a most inopportune time. The owner of this chain and the problems it'll cause him when we come back. Good thing these nitro-burning monsters don't need chains. Top Fuel coming at you later on as well. You know, folks, this is what drag racing is all about. The fans in the stands. A few weeks back in Leicester, New York, Johnny Mancuso, Jay Turner, and many other competitors took to the seats to meet and greet the ticket-buying public. You should always expect to see your favorite racers up close and personal at every IHRA Summit track racing event. Isn't that great? Hey, here's the Nitro Harley points for the Screaming Eagle guys. Jay Turner up top, but Tommy, for how long?
Boy, Jay Turner struggled this weekend and failed to make the show. Same as Freddie Hahn in Pro Modified, the points leader did not qualify. As you can see here, the chain breaking, and that will definitely hurt his points lead.
That takes a big bite out of the Bulldog right there, as that chain keeps the points leader from making the show. And the brackets, Tommy?
Well, who did make the show? Steve Storter and Johnny Mancuso. They've already gained 50 points by advancing to the semifinals over Jay Turner. So let's see if they can put it to good use and make the final rounds today and gain even more points.
All right, here we go with Steve Storter's problems. How about a broken foot? Not a lot of fun when you're trying to hang on to a 215-mile-an-hour nitro missile. Storter, the subject of our Holly Presents feature.
That's the instinct thing that you get when you first start to ride one of these. After years of riding one, you'll actually feel the bike make a move before it does.
Steve Storter had dreams of racing bikes since his teenage years and has spent the past 26 making those dreams a reality. He's been the protege of several big-name drag racers, like the late Elmer Trett, as well as current teammate Johnny Mancuso. Steve says he's enjoyed the ride, but will never forget how tough it was getting there.
Your first race is pretty hard on you emotionally. I mean, well, the time I got done with that first race, I was a mess. It's just the stress, the excitement of it. It's hard to explain until you do it.
There are always a lot of distractions come race time, so Steve keeps his mind on the job at hand. Otherwise, it's easy to get lost in trouble.
The biggest thing I concentrate on is getting straight to the line, because these things are extremely hard to control once they leave. If they start drifting on you one way or the other, it's almost impossible to bring them back.
Steve is bullish on winning and says he won't back off if he meets his boss in the finals.
You don't want to win that way. I mean, that's no fun. Even Johnny told me, he said he wouldn't sleep at night if he told me to back out of the throttle. So, I mean, I'm sure he spends a lot of money and a lot of time. He wants to win that championship. But on the other hand, it's no fun to win a race if it's given to you. I mean, it's a lot more fun to earn one.
I haven't been doing that well this weekend. I mean, we've been having a lot of trouble getting down the track, smoking the tire and different things like that, but at least my body is all still in pretty decent shape.
Speaking of such things, Steve, we understand a broken foot somewhere between your number one qualifying pass and your first pass. How'd you do it?
I fell backwards last night. Just kind of broken my toes.
Did you trip?
I don't really remember. It happened pretty quick.
We both got tough competition. Jim's still in, Bill's still in. So, I mean, we both have a couple of tough rounds. So, it's just probably how it all falls, how it all shakes out. If we don't smoke the tire, I think we can give Jim a real good run. This old bike here has been pretty consistent. I think Steve can do a good job with it. And, hopefully we'll see each other in the final.
Well, Steve, next time you qualify number one, go to bed early.
I will.
That 750-plus horsepower of nitro-powered Harley engine spinning those big rear-wheel tires. Bill Furr and Steve Storter match up in our first semifinal pair.
Well, look at the reaction time for Storter. 4:37. A sore foot or broken foot isn't bothering him at all. Look at that thing carry the front end on the other end of the racetrack. That is a picture-perfect run with a great reaction time and a 6:59 ET.
211-mile-an-hour pass for Storter.
Get him set on the bike and let him go.
Semifinals. There's Mancuso. Those 750 horsepower engines are stuffed into just a 630-pound bike. So Jim McClure here in this brightly colored machine going up against Johnny Mancuso.
Mancuso wanting to make this an all-Mancuso final up against Storter in the final round. But Jim McClure thinks otherwise as McClure pulls out the victory. 6:55 to Mancuso, 6:64. He had to run that better ET because he was late on the start line with Mancuso getting the jump.
He had it at both ends, 216 miles an hour. Strong run from McClure. So we've got, we'll unveil the stealth.
That roller deck 4x4.
He could hear a car the work we'd...
You can participate in the ride-along program in a two-seater. Check out the Wix Top Dragster experience at a track near you.
Well, Ralph, Steve's daughter will be in the final round, and he's going
to... Like this, Johnny will break the other foot.
Probably. At least we'll have one bike in the finals.
Was there any pain on that? The only pain might have been that you didn't run a little faster, because McClure says he's got a 40 in the bike.
Yeah, he's got a 40, but we know this one will do 40s too. So we'll step it up a little bit and see what happens.
It's been a pretty good week.
Pretty good week. I've had bad luck long enough. It's time to turn it around.
Where did that run come from? I mean, did you know it was in the bike all along?
Oh, yeah. I just, you know, you just fight the gremlins all the time, and every now and then you get one together.
All right, Tommy, how about the practice for the Screaming Eagle Nitro Harleys?
Well, we can see how they got to the final. Steve Storter, number one qualifier. But Jim McClure been really getting the tune-up on that bike to come around, qualifying the number seven position. And as they come into the day, he's actually the favorite in the final with the EP performance advantage.
There's that burnout where Storter's having trouble with his foot, and not a real big burnout. You think that'll affect him?
Well, you did notice that he did a real short burnout, probably not wanting to get his foot on the ground too much, be real careful with it. But once the engine fires on these things, Ralph, you forget you even got a broken leg. I mean, you have to concentrate on what you're doing. And we can see McClure's bike have some problems. He brakes, has to shut it off. Given the wind, the Storter, a 648, that would have been tough to beat, but we'll never know. McClure having problems. Storter picking up 70 points on points leader Jay Turner. Definitely what he's trying to do for the championship chase.
Well, McClure wins the battle at the starting line, but it's the one at the finish line that makes the difference. As the crews share pleasantries at the top end, Storter's your winner.
This is a major here for Team Mancuso. Right now, you guys are in a position to do some damage for the rest of the year.
Yeah, Jay going out first, you know, not qualifying, really helped us out a whole bunch. So I think that puts me and Johnny within 20 points and probably within about 40 of Jay. So this is going to help a lot. Now it's going to be an interesting race for the rest of the year.
It really will. Well, on the trophy, it says, you know, Mopar Parts, World Nationals. You're the champion, buddy. Great job.
Oh, appreciate it. Thanks, Aaron.
Well, there's Jay Turner barely sitting on top of the point standings, and Storter and Mancuso, they seem to be licking their chops to get a hold of the Bulldog. Hey, stay with us, because TNN Sports is coming right back to Norwalk. We got the hot action of Pro Stock coming your way, and of course, we've got the Kings of Drag Racing Top Fuel still to show you. Stay with us. Stop.
Oh, you definitely get a backfire under the hood or a leaky fuel line. There's a lot of fire there, but drivers protected by a firewall and a fire suit, and that's why they wear them.
What happened?
I think there was leaky fitting in the main line, and we didn't catch it till late, and that's what happens, you know.
Any damage to the car? Any major damage to the car?
Not really. Not a lot of major damage. Mostly just burned up wires.
Glad you're okay.
Yeah, so am I, you know.
Let's take a look at the Sunoco Pro Stock points, where you see Ron Miller on top, but the gap is closing. You know, Miller had been on a tear, but all of a sudden, Yoke moves up into second, and Montecalvo's still in the thick of things, too. One hiccup in Miller's schedule so far, and it has all changed, Tommy.
Well, you can see how important every round win is here at Stanton, Michigan. Ron Miller has some problems. One round he lost there, now he's got a tight points battle on his hands as Greg Mosier walks back to pits in dejection.
Yoke, meanwhile, has been running so strong, has moved up to second, and Montecalvo trying to hang in there.
Montecalvo doing a great job being consistent, but Yoke is quietly moving into second place with a couple runner-up finishes.
And here's a look at the Sunoco Pro Stock ladder. Miller comes in eighth. He's going to match up with Montecalvo in the semis.
We're talking about how every round win is important. John Yoke trying to make a challenge for the championship, and it was his turn to go out on the first round of competition as he red lights away to Tim Neighbors.
Could have been an easy win, but instead he's out and he'll fall in the points. And Spies and Stroop will match up in the other semi on the other side of the lap. Steve Spies and Wally Stroop getting set to go at it now. It's a good look at Spies' car. Here in Norwalk, the Mopar Parts World Nationals. Stroop quicker off the line.
Big advantage. Wally Stroop off the starting line, 0.04 of a second. Speed trying to close the gap, but Stroop take the win with a slow ET. 679 beats a 675.
It was a great drag race too, Tommy.
Well, definitely. It goes down to the wire. Look how close that was, Ralph. The advantage was on the starting line.
You know, Wally, do you realize you won that last race by 1/1,000th of a second?
Yeah, that was pretty close. I didn't know it till I got out. I never looked over the whole time. I know it had to be close.
Your learning curve here is unbelievable. This is something special going on over here in the trim parts camp.
Yeah, we're trying. Hopefully we can make them proud of us.
Well, Wally beat him by just 4 inches. Now Ron Miller, number one in the points, up against John Montecalvo.
Miller trying to get back on track after that first round loss at Stanton, but he won't do it this round as he red lights away. John Montecalvo will take the win and go into the final round at 673. That'll give him lane choice in the final round.
Don't you just love it when a plan comes together?
Oh, I'll tell you, Aaron, that was like somebody took a cement block off my chest. You know, I don't want to wish Ron anything bad, but I saw that red light. I saw it very clearly.
You know, and at the same time, you also ran low ET of the round. You have the advantage going into this final round. You're going to have lane choice. Any particular choice of lane?
We're going to stay in that left. We're not changing anything. I mean, we've ran good in the left. The crew is doing an excellent job. Steve's got the clutch dialed in for the left, and that's where we're going.
All right, here we go with the Sunoco Pro Stock Final here in Norwalk. John Montecalvo, he's had that Citgo car running strong all day. Wally Stroop only needed 4 inches to win in his semifinal. Might need more than that to put away Montecalvo.
Well, definitely. Montecalvo trying to get this round win, close the gap in the points. A 4:08 reaction time, almost perfect. 400 is perfect. It's going to be tough to beat that. As you can see, Montecalvo pull away. 674 beats a 677. Wally Stroop would have had to run an outstanding ET to beat that 4:08 reaction time. Montecalvo was ready for that final round.
Montecalvo, he's your winner here at Norwalk.
Well, John Montecalvo, you have been waiting for this one for a long time.
Aaron, it's been incredible. This is the fourth final we've been in, and I'm just so happy to win this thing for my crew, Sonny Lennett. Two Sonny cars in a final. Can't find anything better than that. We've had a tremendous amount of help with us this weekend. Steve did an excellent job with the clutch, and I'm just overjoyed. And we might be in a points lead. I don't know. If not, it's close.
And the pressure, that pressure from all year long, is finally off.
Oh, man, Aaron, I'll tell you what. It couldn't come at a better race, neither. The biggest race of the year for us, and I am overjoyed.
Well, I'll take a look at the Sunoco Pro Stock point standings now. Montecalvo by 1 over Ron Miller as the Citgo Chevy makes its way to victory lane here in Norwalk. Great weekend for Montecalvo. Well, they've been taking those Stealth sponsor stickers off all weekend long. We'll have the answer as to who is that secret sponsor when we come back to Norwalk.
This has been just a fun program all the way around, but I'm really glad to let the people know exactly who we are. We are obviously eAuto. We're everything automotive. Go to the website, check it out. No longer top secret confidential anymore, but that was a neat program, but we are here.
And now time to take a look at the point standings for Top Fuel. Paul Romine on top of Bruce Linton, and this has been a heck of a battle all year. 50 points for Romine. That's not a lot in this division. Top Fuel brackets, Tommy.
Here's how they qualify. Clay Milliken with a 471 ET. If he can back that up, that is a new IHRA record. Someone who's missing from the ladder, Louis Allison, and that is our Mopar feature of the week.
We've seen the name Louis Allison a lot lately. He's driving Jack Ostrander's car. Well, Louis took a big fall in the Night of Fire qualifying. He lost the right rear tire around 600 feet, which tore off the wing around 900 feet down track.
Okay.
Louis was in for a wild ride, and he came to rest nearly a half a mile from the starting line. We feared the worst, but the IHRA mandated safety features on these cars saved his life.
Sitting in the car, you know, and still kind of new at this game, so I couldn't tell you what happened. I mean, the car was marching pretty good, and then all of a sudden it just made a violent left turn, and I was trying to get it back, and the next thing I know, it was in the wall. So, I mean, I don't know what happened. I can't believe I broke my buddy's hot rod.
Certainly a scary ride, but Louis told us they'll be at Epping with a backup car, and they're looking to buy another one from Joe Amato. J.R. Todd up against Jim Bailey here in round number one.
Bailey struggled this year, looking to turn it around. J.R. Todd, a newcomer, 18 years old, trying to get a handle on Top Fuel, but he won't today as he smokes the tires. Bailey, 4.77, nice run, taking the win.
Now we've got Jim Head in the far lane, going up against Paul Romine in the near lane.
Romine leading the points, wants to stay out on the lead. Every round win to him is very valuable, trying to stretch out that lead, but Jim Head's got other ideas today. Jim Head, first off his starting line, is streaking away. We've seen two cars smoke the tires in the right lane. Jim Head, 488.
You can be sure everybody will be paying attention to that as they march on to the next round.
Well, the quicker car has lane choice, so Bruce Litton, his quicker qualified car, he took the left-hand lane. He's seen two cars smoke the tires in the right, so he switched and went to the left.
Pretty wise move for the driver of the Wix Filters car. Oh, and he heats the hides up.
Well, so much for that theory, Ralph. You see a drop cylinder on Wayne Bailey's car, but ugly win, but he takes the win anyway as Litton smokes the tires in the left lane.
Clay Milliken in the new eAuto.com sponsored car.
Almost dead even off the start line, but look at Clay Milliken. The performance of that car really running well. 4.77, just not quite quick enough to back up his earlier 4.71.
Well, he puts away Reed, though, and how about those brackets, Tommy?
Well, we're into the semifinal round, and then they're gone in the first round of competition. Number one and two in the points, giving Clay Milliken and a few other guys a chance to close the gap.
And on to the first pair of the semis, Jim Head in the same lane that he ran earlier today.
The performance of his car is really coming around, Ralph. He's starting to figure out the IHRA tune-up. The car is running a lot better, and here he is in the semifinals up against Wayne Bailey.
Head quicker off the line and just pulls away.
It's all horsepower there. 491 beats Wayne Bailey's 535. Jim Head going to the final.
Now here's Bailey, who's going to go up against Clay Milliken.
Milliken's car's been really strong all season long. Bailey struggled a little bit. You'd expect the performance of that car to be a little better than it has been, but he's going to have a tough time up against Clay Milliken, that eAuto.com car. That car's really strong, trying to back up the IHRA ET record, and he's in the lane he was in earlier, so we'll have to see how he does, see if he can get that record back up and go to the final round, close the points gap.
Milliken quicker, but can the step-on car get him at the far end? No. And the eAuto.com machine takes the win and goes on to another final. Big problems for Bailey. A lot of parts hurt on that car.
Well, he's probably threw the rods out of the engine. The oil's got on the header, ignited the fire, and just burning behind him. That's why the driver sits in front of these cars. But quite a bit of oil you can see out the side of the car. It's got on the side pot of that car, and just a little minor fire, nothing big. You know, you don't see him in any big hurry to get out of there. But that's why they put these engines behind him.
Well, the finals are coming up in Top Fuel. Stay with us. TNN's coming back to Norwalk.
This portion of the IHRA Summit Drag Racing Series is brought to you by Mopar Parts, the Mopar difference, and by the 4,000 Carquest Auto Parts stores across North America. You'll find it at Carquest. And by Holley, the heart and soul of performance.
Welcome back to Norwalk, and the Top Fuel Finals getting set. Points leader, Paul Romine, he's out in the Carquest car. Number 2 points man, Bruce Litton, the Wix Filters car, he's gone as well. That leaves us Clay Milliken in the new eAuto.com sponsoring machine, going up against Jim Head, looking for his first win of the year.
As you head into your first final round here in 2000, do you prepare any differently? Do you think any differently? I know you're up there in your little perch staring at the computer, as you always do, but is there a different feeling right now?
Not really. It's just another run. I've been doing this too long, I guess. I'd very much like to win the race, but I try to approach each run exactly the same, and I pretty much try to race the clock and let the other guy do what he has to.
Okay, you're in a final round. You do have a chance for a world record. Do you try and spin the earth or just get it right on the racetrack, take the points, take the win?
We're taking the points and take the win. If the record comes with it, great. If it don't, you know, that's fine too, because, man, what a weekend. No matter what happens, I mean, what a weekend. We unveiled the eAuto thing, and we're here and in the final. I'm all about it.
What a weekend. What a year for Clay Milliken, Tommy.
Well, you can see Clay Milliken reaching the final. What a way to debut a new sponsor. And number one and two in the points, gone first round. But he's got a tough competitor when racing Jim Head in the final round.
Milliken stealth sponsor. Actually was a pretty well-kept secret for the first time in racing. But boy, he's going to have his hands full going up against Jim Head.
Well, definitely. Clay Milliken's got a little performance advantage coming in here. He's had the quicker ET each round. Jim Head's going to have to step it up if he expects to take the win.
But, Tommy, he's still not as experienced as Jim Head. How many tricks does Head have to use here?
Well, Jim Head's got years and years of experience in top fuel, always the experimenter. But I don't think you'll see him experiment when it comes to the final round. Jim's all about winning the race.
Milliken in the good lane this weekend. And it helps him up the line, but not by much.
Well, both of them leave dead even. You can see something go away on Jim Head's car down towards the top end. The speed falling off to only 289. And that's what cost him, giving the win to Clay Milliken.
What a weekend for Milliken. New sponsor to win.
Well, you can see they're both dead even off the starting line. Both cars right down the middle of the course. There, something going away on Jim Head's car, blowing the blower off of it, it looked like.
This was unbelievably important.
It was really important. eauto.com, first race unveiled, we won. And it was Norwalk, the biggest race of the year. I can't get any better than this except to kiss you again.
That wasn't all that special, believe me. Clay, right now, I mean, you are definitely in the hunt for the world championship.
We definitely made up some ground this weekend. I tell you what, I got the greatest crew. I mean, this is unbelievable. I hate to repeat things, but January 31st, we didn't know how to work on this thing. Two races, three finals. We are kicking butt.
As you take a look at the points, he might not be the points leader, but Clay Milliken, definitely the story of Top Fuel this year as he sits third behind Romine and Litton.
Mopar Pro Modified points. Wayne Stott has pulled out into lead. Freddie Hahn not making a show. It really cost him this weekend, falling to second.
IHRA.com Funny Car points. Scott Winnie starting to stretch it out now over Vaughn Smith and Jimmy Rector.
The Screaming Eagle Nitro Harley points. Jay Turner lost a lot of points this weekend as he also not qualified. Steve Storter won the race and closed the gap.
Arguably the best points battle right here in Sunoco Pro Stock. Just 1 point. Montecalvo leads Miller.
Your champions for this weekend, Wayne Stott in the Mopar Pro Modified.
On IHRA.com Funny Car, Scott Winnie takes the win as he lengthens his points lead.
Screaming Eagle Nitro Harley, Steve Storter, broken foot and all, take the win.
John Manicalvo gets the Sunoco Pro Stock win and the points lead.
And Clay Milliken debut on the eauto.com new sponsor, got him a win.
Well, it's been a great weekend here in Norwalk. Make sure you check in tnnonline.com for more information about the IHRA racing. And there's a lot more Summit Drag Racing coming your way. Rockingham, the next event for the CarQuest Autumn Nationals. Get your tickets. We'll see you at the Rock. And tune in next week to catch our show from Epping, New Hampshire. Should be a great one. Great air up there. For Aaron and Tommy, I'm Ralph Sheen. So long from Norwalk.